Hello everyone, I'm Alicia. Welcome to my Beautiful Nights channel. For this video, I'm going to show you another haul from BB Craft. This time, I ordered things from China and from the USA. First, I'm going to show the things that I got from China, and then I'll show you later on, I'll split it up, things that I got from USA in this video. So, before I show you what I got, I am going to share with you a coupon code, and I'll put it right here somewhere in the video. In a previous BB Craft haul, I got these really pretty chandelier findings. They're antique brass, and I've been dying to make this necklace. I have a design stuck in my head with these findings, and I went to go do it, but I have the wrong colored wire. So this is antique brass colored wire, okay, and this is antique brass chandelier findings. Now, I don't know if my camera is showing this or not, but this wire here looks brown. It's like a chocolatey brown. It does not match this. In real life, I can't really tell on my camera, but I don't know what you're seeing, but this here does not match this. It's like a chocolatey brown. So, BB Craft, I was really happy because I discovered that they sell permanently colored wire. So here is their wire, and it is way closer to this here. It actually, I think it matches it perfectly. So they're calling theirs antique bronze, and this one's antique brass. That's upside down. See right there? Antique brass, antique bronze. But look at the color difference. Do you see how this one's brown and this one has the like true antique brass color to it? So see that? See the difference? I'm really happy that I found this because I wanted to work on this necklace so bad, and I think you guys are going to love the project I have, but I just didn't want to use this wire with it because I feel like it clashes. It's a weird off color. It's beautiful. I love that brown color, but it just doesn't match my findings the way I wanted it to. So I got this wire in three different sizes. I got an 18 gauge, right there's the size. I got a 24 gauge, and I got a 20 gauge. These are the sizes I use the most. I also wanted to get a 26 gauge, but I ended up not doing that and just got what I needed for the time. And I also got gunmetal colored wire, which I have been wanting forever. Here it is. Now this here, I will say, I don't have actual, like the other brand I just showed you, Artistic Wire. I don't have a gunmetal in that brand. But I do want to say that that one, when I look at it on the computer screen, is more of a hematite color. This one is more black. But I still like it. I'm very happy with it. And I got the gunmetal in three sizes, just like I did the antique bronze or brass, whatever you want to call it. So there is a 24, the 20, and I also got it in an 18 gauge, the sizes I use the most of. And I realized I have silver colored wire in aluminum and stainless steel. I have like no regular permanently colored wire that's silver. Mine's all just aluminum or stainless steel. So I also got 24 gauge in the silver color, 20 gauge in the silver color, and 18 gauge in the silver color. It's a bright silver. So the aluminum wire is a grayer, it's like a grayish silver color, and then the stainless steel wire is a darker color. So there are different shades of silver, believe it or not. Okay, so this is my wire, and I might have to stop filming at times to clean my desk off because I have so much stuff on it, and I don't want to mix up what I already showed you and what I haven't showed you. So this here's a big item that I can show you now. I could not believe that I found this on their site. I was looking at, this is a bracelet mandrel, a bangle mandrel. I was looking at one of these on Amazon probably a year ago or so. I want to say that it was $20, maybe $25. It was up there in price. But the one that I saw didn't have the graduated steps like this. It was just like, it was smooth. It didn't have the steps. I hope this is making sense to you. But this here is stepped. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to take my measuring tape here, and I'm going to measure this and see what the size is, and then I'll know for my bangles. It's going to be really cool, and this is kind of multi-purpose for me because I can use this as a bracelet mandrel to make bracelets and bangles, but I can also use it to take pictures on, because sometimes when I make jewelry and I go to take pictures of it, for my camera battery just died, so I don't know where I left off talking at. But anyways, I am really happy that I was able to find this. And by the way, this comes, the one I chose, comes with a hammer. There was another one that was $11 and something that was just the mandrel. And then for two something more, I think it was. I'm not totally sure. It's been some time since I was on there. But this one here came with a hammer. And this is so much nicer than the one I have. And this is for work hardening the metal. Now, the one I have, I've showed you the one I have in previous videos where I was making rings, has a wooden handle, and the handle is like this long. It's so short. This one has a much longer handle. And look at how nice the handle is. And these screw off. And this is the rubber side, and I think this is the nylon side. But anyways, I was really happy that I could get the pair of them. It was 13 something. I'll have links, just like I usually do, down there in the description bar of all the things that I got from them, so you guys can go and check this out. But if you are looking into getting a bracelet mandrel, look at the other one, because I don't know, you might want that one more. Like I said, this one here is stepped, and the other one is just a smooth surface. So I'm really happy about that. I think it's cool, and it's going to be a lot of fun to work with. Okay. I have to move some things over here. So I got some green 6-0 seed beads. Now, the seed beads aren't perfectly uniform, but that's fine. It just depends on what I need them for. Now, there are uniform ones in here. I just have to pick them out. But this is a really pretty green color, and I do have a project in mind for this, and I'm hoping that it's going to work out. And I think this is a pound of seed beads. Now, when I went to their 6-0 seed beads and I was looking at it, when you click on a color, you have to see where it's shipping from. Some of them ship from China, some of them shipped from the U.S. This one here is from China. I did get some other seed bead colors that are from the U.S., and I'll show you those when I go to do that one. I'm going to go ahead and put this back in the bag. Okay, so I also reordered these beads. Oh my gosh, I'll be back. I gotta go get. So, a few videos back, I filmed a tutorial using these purple agate beads, Madagascar agate, and I love this cuff so much. It's gorgeous. Anyways, the beads that I used for this are from BB Craft, and I just about used all of them in this cuff, so I ordered some more of these. I only have a few of them left, and I love these so much, and I'll open them up for you. They are just beautiful. Oops, I got some runaways. They're really pretty. And like I said, I used them in this cuff here. I did the 6mm here and the 8 here. You can find a tutorial for this on my channel. And I also got them, again, in the 8mm because I love them so much. And like I said, I just about used all of them. I only have a few left. Actually, don't see the 6. Oh, here it is. 8. This is the 8mm. So here they are in the 8. They're gorgeous. I love them so much. And they're faceted. And I also ordered these here. I've been dying to have these. Last time I made an order, they didn't have them in stock. They have these beads in two different sizes. There is a 6 millimeter and, wait, was it 6? I have to check. I think maybe it's, these are 10. These are 8. So there's an 8 millimeter and a 10 millimeter. So these are the 10. Now I think the 10 millimeter is a synthetic, so it's man-made, and the 8 millimeter is natural. But this is a giant clamshell beads. They are gorgeous. Do you see the markings on them right there? They're really pretty. So these, I think, are the synthetic man-made ones. I think that's what it said on the website. The 10 millimeter, they were cheaper. These were 3-something a strand. And the other strand was 7-something. So I want to say that these were the synthetic. And the other ones were the natural clamshell. But these are gorgeous. There aren't a whole lot of white, opaque white beads out there. You can get them in glass, but like natural, just the entire bead, opaque white, I don't see it very often. So I'm happy to get those. And I also got, where is my knife? Here it is. I also got some stainless steel ball head pins. I was looking into buying these, I think it was on Amazon, probably like 2 years ago. I don't know, it's been a long time. And first of all, they were really hard to find. And then when I found them, they were so expensive and overpriced that I didn't end up buying them. But I couldn't, and there was like barely any in the pack. And now, you know, time's gone by. I'm sure that they're everywhere now. But I think there was 500 head pins in this pack, ball head pins in 5 different sizes. So there's like 100 of each size. But they are perfect. Look at them. They do not tarnish. They are stainless steel. They will not bother your skin. They won't rust. These are awesome for making earrings. I got the stainless steel leverbacks. I told you guys about this before. And the last order I made with BB Crafts, I got these stainless steel bead caps. So these would be perfect for earrings that you can wear all the time. And I mean all the time, like swim in them, shower in them. They're not going to discolor on you. This ring here that I wear a lot, this rose ring, is actually a stainless steel ring. And back in the day, I paid like $20 for it on QVC. And then one day I just saw it on Amazon for like $2. And it's the same exact ring. How crazy is that? So anyways, I got these ball head pins. They are really pretty. And they're a thick gauge. They look like they're 20 gauge, I'm going to say. So you can see that these here are longer. They're short, so there's different lengths. See how short these are, and these ones are longer? So there's 5 different lengths, and there is, I think there was 500 of them. Does it say it here? No, I don't see it. Okay. All right. I also got these rondelles. They are super duper teeny tiny. They are so small. I have this rondelle size in a rainbow iris and I want to say a purple, but I don't have many of them. They're pricey because they are so tiny. These are not 4 millimeter. I think these are like 2 by 3 millimeter. They're super super small. And look at how cute this box is. Oh, wow. See how tiny they are? They are just so small. Really pretty colors, too. And I didn't check to see how many are in here, but this is filled to capacity, as you can see. There's a lot. I love this teal-looking color. It's gorgeous. Really pretty. I love all of the colors. And every compartment is taped shut. as you can see right here. There's tape on all of them, which is great because none of them are going to fall out. But this is a neat container. I haven't seen a container like this yet. There's a lot of beads in here. Okay, so I got that. And I also got some 12 gauge aluminum wire to use with my new bangle mandrel. And this is dented because I opened this in the kitchen and I dropped it on the floor. Thank God it was in a box, because I probably would have cracked the spool. And oh my gosh, again, every time I get a package from BB Craft, everything is packaged so well. I'm telling you, I've never seen a company package things as well as they do. What an amazing service they have. So this is the 12 gauge wire, and I think this is where it starts. So this is kind of like a coat hanger size. Oh my gosh, I am excited to work with this. Oh yeah, this is going to be fun. Okay, this is going to be awesome. I'm really excited about this. And holy cow, there is a lot in here. Look at that. Right there, there's a lot of wire in here. I think it was AC Moore. I bought a thick gauge wire like this before, and it was pricey, and I barely got any wire. There wasn't a lot. Actually, it didn't even come on a spool. It was just wound up on like a piece of cardboard. So this is an awesome deal. There is a lot of wire on here. Okay, and I also got some more bead caps, because if you watched my gemstone chip lariat, I think that's what I called it, I used a lot of bead caps. I used like half of the bead caps that I had gotten in my order. So I got these here, and I actually had wanted these in a previous haul, but they sold out on me. They were out of stock, and I'm so happy that they came back in stock. These are the most incredible bead caps I've ever seen, especially in a collection like this. I'm going to go through them and show you guys. They're so beautiful. Every single one of them is stunning. Okay, we'll start on the back side. So there's these here. See how cool these are? And these are not filigree. They look like they're filigree, but they're thick, heavy metal. See how thick it is? It's not thin like filigree. It has these big holes in the sides, so if you want, you could hang jump rings and like chain from here. You can make beaded tassels, earrings. That would be cool. Whenever you have a bead cap like this that has holes on it, you can hang a chain from it. It's another place to connect things. Here is another one. I think this one is a flower. It's a flower. This one's pretty. This one looks like it would work on maybe a 12 or 14 millimeter bead. This one, maybe a 10 or 12. This one here is stunning. This one would also be great for like a bead cone on the end of a necklace or bracelet. It depends on how thick the piece is that you're making, but look at how stunning and fancy. Man, is that fancy. And they have nice large holes, so I can also use these on cord if I want. Here is another one. These are beautiful too. I can't believe how pretty they are. This is like the best selection I've ever seen, like this, and bead caps. Here are some more. These are also stunning. Here's another flower one. They're so drop dead gorgeous. I love them so much. I can see why these sell out a lot, because they're so beautiful. Look at how fancy this one is. This one's so fancy. Like, every single one of these I would pick out and buy. I like all of them. These here are beautiful, and they kind of have a flat shape to them. They're not domed a lot. And if you guys remember, a while back I did a tutorial on a beaded bottle. I did two different beaded bottles. I did one that was small, and it was kind of an easy project, and then I did one that was more difficult, and it was a larger bottle. And anyways, I covered the cork with a bead cap, and I needed a bead cap that was kind of flat and large, and these would be perfect for that because they're large and they have the flat look to them, and they're just really fancy. They're beautiful, and I love this box. This box has a hinge on the back, and then it has the hinge latches, so it's going to last for many, many, many years. Here are some smaller caps. These look like they would work on an 8mm bead. These are also really pretty. Oh, look at these. They're all so gorgeous. I love those too. And here are some bead cones. These are really fancy. And I love the antique look. This one here is also like a bead cone. They're all so beautiful. And I'm really happy that they put all of them in bags, because with my problems, my water problems in my house, this keeps them from tarnishing. So that's awesome that they did that. These here are gorgeous. It's like a bud, like a rosebud or something. A flower. Those are also gorgeous. And then, oh, these are small. They're so cute. So I have bead caps like this, but mine are much bigger. These are small. They're really pretty. And these are shinier than the ones I got. The ones I have look dull. They're not shiny silver. They're like a dull, almost like matte looking silver. They're kind of strange, actually. And here are some more. These look like they're from Bali. How they have that rope and the beaded edge. They're pretty fancy. I love all of these. And I think that this box was 8 or 9 something. I think. I'm not totally sure because I got so many different things. And it's been a while since I made the order, so I don't remember. But wow. These are awesome. These will last me for a long time. Unless I do another necklace like the Lariat one I did where I used a whole bunch of them. Okay. So there is one thing left in the order from China, and it's this here. This is the mesh what's it called? It's like rhinestone, but it's not actually rhinestone. It's a mesh, like imitation rhinestone ribbon. People use this all the time in craft projects. This one's in gold. I also got one in silver. The one in silver is from the US, so I'll show you that one next. And it is absolutely beautiful. And by the way, you can buy this stuff from the Dollar Tree, but it comes on a very tiny roll. I want to say it's like 4 or 5 wide at the Dollar Tree. And it's like a really small ribbon roll. It's super tiny, okay? It's like this big. Now this is totally huge. Look how big this is. My fingers barely meet going all the way around. It is a ton. So I have two projects in store with this for Christmas project, so I hope you guys will like that too. It's something I haven't really done much of, and I think you will enjoy it. So now I'm going to clean off my desk and go get the stuff from the US order, and I'll show you what I got. Here is the roll that I got from the US, and by the way, these were really cheap. This was like 8 something for this roll, and this was like 11. That's dirt cheap if you could go and look at the craft stores and how small of a roll that you get. It's so small compared to this. This is going to last me a lifetime. So here is the silver. And there is just a ton on here. And I have to say, when I looked at the picture, I'm like, holy cow, that is a lot. And then when I got it in person, it's even more. So when you look at the picture, you're thinking it's a lot. But when you actually get it, it's double the size of what you thought it was going to be. That's how I feel. I feel like it's double the size. There is a ton here. I didn't expect it to be that much, but wow. What an awesome deal that was. Okay, I have bags falling on the floor behind me. So here are some more seed beads. And this is one of my favorite seed bead colors. They're so beautiful. It's a iris mix. It's a rainbow iris. The purple, blue, green. There's like bronze. Beautiful colors. And again, these aren't perfectly uniform, but that's okay. Because not all the projects I do have to have perfectly uniform beads. I like to use all different kinds of seed beads. So I got that color, and I also got a white because I am running very low on my white 6-0 seed beads. And by the way, all the seed beads I got are 6-0s. They also had 8-0s in different sizes. So these are white 6-0 seed beads. And these would be perfect for my 3D beaded snowman that I make. I have a tutorial on that. And I also got brown. Now, a while back, I did a tutorial on a bird nest ring. And I had a really hard time finding brown. Good grief. Brown seed beads. So this brown here is a dark brown. It's like a reddish brown, I would say. Brown, opaque seed beads are kind of hard to find. But I don't have any brown opaque seed beads in a 6-0, so I got these. And I also got some more of the giant clamshell beads, and these here I believe were the natural clamshells. I'm going to open it up, and I think I'm going to compare it with the other one. So these are supposed to be the natural. The 10mm, these were supposed to be the synthetic ones, I think. Watch me have this wrong. You'll find out if you go to the links and see, or I'll find out after this video if I have this wrong or not. But I think the 10mm was the synthetic one, and the 8mm was the real. Which, I gotta say, looking at both of them, this one looks real to me, and this one looks fake. I wonder if there's a coating on these, or if they're all natural. The 8mm ones are like super duper white. And these here, I do see patterns on them. Do you see right here? Do you see that circle on the bead? I don't really see that in the 8mm ones. So I got two of the 8mm strands. They're really pretty. I don't think they're coated. And I say that because if they were coated, they would not be on this string. They would be on monofilament. They're pretty neat. I like them. They're gorgeous. Okay, I have one thing left, I think. I'm going to move this aside. I think that's it. So these here are bead cones. And I bought some just like these at Walmart, but they only have them in silver. At least they do at my Walmart. And they are gorgeous. They are so pretty. And I was so happy to see that Beanie Craft has them in all of the colors. So there is a gold, antique copper, antique silver, and antique brass. They are absolutely drop-dead gorgeous. I love them. And they're not round bead caps, they're actually like oval. See that there? They're so fancy. Really fancy. Look at the gold ones. Man, they're so gorgeous. Maybe I can use these in that necklace. I might be able to. I'm going to try it. So there they are. And I forgot how many were in here. But there's a lot. There's a lot in this box. And they're really good quality. They're heavy duty. This is it. I hope you found this haul video helpful to you. I will put links to everything I got in this video down there in the description bar. And I will also put up the coupon code again for you, just in case you see anything you want, put the coupon code in and it'll save you money. And I hope you enjoyed this video. Please like this video, leave me a comment, subscribe if you want to see more of my videos, and don't forget to click the bell button so you get notified when I upload new videos, and like me on Facebook. And don't forget to share pictures of the jewelry you've made from my videos on my Facebook page and follow me on Pinterest. Thanks for watching.